Today, Drew and T are off to the Liverpool Metropolitan Cathedral, one of the most iconic Catholic churches in Great Britain. I've heard that the cathedral houses relics and items from all the Catholic churches that have closed in the surrounding Liverpool area.
I think this one is possibly the biggest church clearance or religious building clearance we've ever done.
Sadly, though, we have a Presbyterian chapel-sized van.
Oh, yeah, there is that, yeah.
I'm intrigued to see what he's going to come back with.
Hi. Hello. You all right?
Wow. That's quite an effect, isn't it?
As soon as you come in, you see the altar.
You're drawn straight
to
it, aren't you?
That's what's straight there.
Incredible.
The glass is a fabulous feature, and it creates a sort of a changing light throughout the day.
But the glass, what I love about the glass, is the tiny little specks of red every now and again.
That's right.
So it leads your eye up to it.
But it's not the cathedral above ground that's tempted Drew to Liverpool. It's the treasures that are stored beneath in the stunning crypt.
I love that window where they've done the cross, and that's really clever. I've had access to some staggering buildings in my time, but this is right up there. You know, this is an iconic building, a landmark of the Northwest and of the Catholic Church. So to be down in the belly of it, being able to buy things, is really, it's quite exciting, really.
In the bowels of the cathedral are the storerooms, where years of ecclesiastical artifacts from the diocese are kept.
Right, so we're going into the bowels of the cathedral now.
Wow. God, sack the cleaner.
Look at this. This is where everything is dumped or stored or whatever.
So the stuff that's down here, this comes from all the different churches around the area, because you've got some nice pews there.
Yeah, pews and lots and pews and pews and pews,
pews and
all
pews.
Different eras.
These pews that we've got thousands of in here now, the fashion for them is just completely gone. I think everybody who wanted a pew has got one, because there's thousands, if not millions, of them out there.
Oh, my word. Look at this.
I mean, some of this has been stored for a long time, some of the woodwork here. As you can see, there's a lot of benches over that side, but here is other things.
Altar pieces and, and that reredos there. At one time in my warehouse, I had 13 pulpits. Yeah. They're not a big seller.
Not sure what you do with them, actually. Some of the kneelers, obviously, we
still use.
It's a hodgepodge of everything, really.
But amongst the unwanted pews, Drew's salvage-seeking eyes spot something.
That chair's quite interesting.
Things are very dusty.
A bit broken. Where did that little chair come from?
I can't remember.
I don't know.
To be honest, no.
This Victorian ecclesiastical chair, with its Gothic arcaded tracery back, would have been placed on the sanctuary for an assistant member of the clergy. It needs a little restoration, but in its current state, it could be worth around £350.
So this chair, would that be of interest to selling?
Because of its condition, probably yes, if you were interested. But
it's an odd one. It's lovely quality, and to have it made today would cost a fortune,
an arm and a
really.
Leg.
But it's a tricky one.
It's probably still got the original.
It's got the original horsehair. I'm just trying to feel. Yeah, that has been put over. You can feel.
Yeah.
Pull that off.
Probably been recovered. Yeah.
And because underneath it, they've left the original cover. Yeah. Hopefully. £180.
£200. I let it go. Okay.
Deal. There's a little bit of work to do to the frame. It's a little rickety. That design of chair always tends to be when they don't have a supported back. It's a nice little hall chair. Sit down, sit on, pull your wellies up. It's that type of thing. That's all it's for. Not seen one like that before.
No, and we have no use for that now. The type of candle it takes is no longer used.
Yeah, I'll drag it out so you can see it there. Yeah, I've had a lot of these. That's one of the nicer ones I've seen.
Yeah, it is quite unusual in its shape.
Yeah, usually they're just sort of just a branch, an arm.
Well, they're very heavy there.
Let's see, let's go to the light over there. I just like the colour. The only thing that's attracted me is the colour. There's a box full of the parts there.
Yeah, there's some parts there.
Yeah. None of those bits. No, it's these bits here. See these leaves?
Oh, right, yeah.
This candle stand would have held the votive candles that are used as prayer offerings in the Anglican and Roman Catholic Church. This one is a particularly attractive design and dates back to the 1920s. It could be worth around £300.
There's something nice about it. The base is particularly well made, got really, really good, strong lion's paw feet on it. It's got enough about it to make it saleable for me again, but it mainly just down to the colour, really. I just love the colour of it.
Even though it's very beautiful in its own way, it only has one use, and that's it.
What would you want for it? I think that's what it comes down to. Its commercial value is low.
150.
I was at 100.
Were you?
I really was. Yeah.
Well, so we meet in the middle then.
125.
Okay.
That will end up going privately to somebody who maybe lives in a converted religious building. It's a nice little decorative piece of salvage, really.
The cathedral's extensive storeroom hides still more for Drew.
These would be of interest.
These two?
They're just big. They just take up a lot of wall space. T, can you grab the other end? I just want to tip this forward and see.
They are former rectors of Holland.
Are you all right with that?
Yeah.
These types of portrait paintings are quite common, and pictures like this would frequently be displayed as a mark of respect to an important member of the clergy. Very often, the faces will be painted by a skilled artist, while their less skilled assistants would paint the backgrounds. These two date back to the mid-19th century and could be worth around £1,500 each.
I've had a few of these. They were always done of a huge scale because they generally came from universities or large religious buildings and conference areas, that type of thing. So they were done to sort of basically look down on people and say how great they are. They're very simplistic paintings, but it's an awful lot of bang for your buck, really, with that size of painting.
Give us a clue. What would you be happy with?
I mean, we've nowhere to hang them. The subject matter is of no interest to anybody now.
No. But they're purely now just a decorative thing. That is all they are now. And I've got one client who might be interested in them, that's it. Bought all the other large religious bit paintings I've ever had. He's bought every single one.
£700?
The pair? Yeah. Yeah. Deal.
OK. Right.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Drew spent just over £1,000 on four very saleable items. Before they load up, the Dean has one more treat for Drew and T, an architectural feature inspired by one of the most notable stories of the Bible.
So we have the stone from the Gospel stories where the stone was rolled away.
Oh, I know.
And sort of Christ came out risen from the dead.
Does it roll?
It does. Huh. Would you like to see it roll?
Yes, I would actually, a lot. How do you do it? Is it electronic or what do you do?
It's a hand winch.
Hand crank. Yeah.
The rolling marble gate weighs 6 tons.
OK, stand clear. I'm going to do it, wind it now.
Yeah, go on then. It's been nice to see. Wow. Nice to know. Hiya, you all right?
Yeah, fine.
It's good in here.
I'm off now. See you.
Have you put starters through there?
No.
Pizza through there? Get garlic bread through there?
Hello? Drew? Hello.
Today's been incredibly interesting. We got access into this iconic building. Love it or hate it, it's pretty impressive. Amazing access down into the cellars and also into the crypt. I had no idea all that was there. And then able to buy enormous paintings and bits and bobs from there. It's quite staggering, really.
It's been interesting to chat about some of the artefacts here and also some of the salvage that we have. Even the candle stand, the votive candle stand, surprised me that it would have an interest in somebody's home or whatever, yeah.